A big games awards, some Critical Role meandering, and the stealth Warhammer 40K release of the year.
I fear you're underestimating the sneakiness, sir.
Welcome to Fantasy News Friday, our weekend news rundown. Today we're talking about the last Critical Role of 2024, some big games award news, and a new Warhammer 40K game release. Remember, if you like these kinds of news videos, be sure to like and subscribe them so we can keep making them. Now, on to the news.
Holy shit, there's a lot of news.
Well, Critical Role had another meandering episode, ending 2023 on something of a disjointed and disappointing note. You may remember that Bell's Hells went into the Fey realm in spite of the whole looming apocalypse thing and gods getting Eden scenario.
I know that sounds bad.
The group went there to restore trust in each other after Ashton essentially broke the party by forcibly trying to take control of two Titan shards to give himself some big power-ups, and that didn't really work all that well. So what followed was essentially an episode of team building, with Matt building out some mini-games for the party to complete to play out what was essentially a corporate retreat with slightly higher stakes. Now, we did get some juicy role-playing and lore drops in the form of the party sharing some secret truths with each other, with one cool bit being Fearne talking about her true father, who is the Sorrow Lord of the Unseelie Court. You may remember that from the last time that the party went into the Fey realm. Although, this really felt like the cast just kind of avoiding the whole main storyline and leading to some lingering frustration with fans. We'll probably dive into some of that fan frustration in a later video, but I think ending the year with what essentially was a weird retreat encapsulates a lot of what's been wrong with Campaign 3.
It's also worth pointing out that FCG's truth was that he was beginning to suspect the Changebringer might just be using him. And that means, with FCG now doubting the gods, there's really no one firmly on Team Save the Gods on Bell's Hells anymore, so I hope you enjoy getting a brand new pantheon of gods soon.
The world has a way of changing.
The Game Awards. It had a lot of juicy news, even for a channel like us that doesn't typically focus on video games. But, you know, we're going to run down a lot of fantasy-related stuff. Anyways, the big story, of course, was Baldur's Gate 3 winning Game of the Year and Neil Newbon winning Best Performance of the Year. Of course, the celebrations were a bit disappointing because the Game Awards seemed to focus more on celebrity cameos and commercial spots rather than actually letting the developers and the folks who worked on the game have their time in the sun and celebrate their big wins. But hey, did you notice that new Wizards of the Coast video game announcement? It was one of the first big reveals of the night, and Matthew McConaughey was involved. Near the start of the Game Awards, Archetype Entertainment announced their debut game Exodus, a sci-fi game that deals with the effects of time dilation. Now, Archetype is a new game studio that is owned and controlled by Wizards of the Coast, you know, the folks that make Dungeons & Dragons. The studio is based out of Austin, while Wizards is up in Seattle. And the Archetype is actually headed up by James Olin, who is best known as being one of the creative directors for games like Baldur's Gate and Knights of the Old Republic. And hey, he's also recently been writing D&D books that have been getting published by Wizards of the Coast on the DMs Guild. While Archetype is Wizards' new AAA game studio, they were specifically tasked with creating new IP, which is why they launched Exodus instead of another D&D or Magic game. Now, no release date has been announced for Exodus, but this is, you know, Wizards' first big AAA game. Hopefully it goes better than, you know, Dark Alliance. We want more Baldur's Gate 3 and less Dark Alliance.
I led them away from this world, away from her. We both knew the cost of using the gates. When you travel at light speed, time slows to a crawl. It was only days for me, but an entire lifetime passed for her.
In some other surprising news, The new EA Originals game, Tales of Kenzera Zhao, has a Critical Role connection. The game, which was developed by Abubakar Salim's New Surgent Studios, was developed in collaboration with Critical Role. Now, while details of what this working collaboration entailed isn't cleared, it's likely that there's some sort of financial component of some kind, and it sounds like, based on an interview with GameStop, that Critical Role might have provided some of their tabletop RPG expertise to the game since it was inspired in part by tabletop games. Now, we will also note that Salim is actually has his own Critical Role connections. He voiced Grog's cousin in Tales of Vox Machina, and he's a voice actor, so I'm sure most of the cast knows them. So hopefully we get some more details there, but, you know, there's that Critical Role video game, kind of, sort of, not really, but hey, still looks pretty cool. Can't wait to check it out. In other Game Award announcements, we've got a new Final Fantasy VII Rebirth trailer with a look at Matt Mercer's Vincent Valentine character, and another tease that Aerith is going to get got by Sephiroth.
Sometimes, I don't even know who I am. I forget things everyone else remembers just fine, and know things I've got no right knowing.
Cloud, it's okay. You saved me before. Now it's my turn.
Is it you? You? Or is it the pooch?
I'm just messing with you. That there is our man.
We also got a new Visions of Mana game announcement, marking the first time in 15 years that we got a new Mana series. Also, Matt Mercer appeared at the Game Awards to present a new VR game, which was curious because he was also DMing Critical Role at the exact same time. How could something like that happen?
Well, whenever you notice something like that, a wizard did it.
We're a long ways away from, you know, Laura Bailey ducking out of the Game Awards so that she could go and play, you know, on Critical Role live. Those days are over, unfortunately.
It's over now.
Anyways, and finally, Warhammer 40K is getting the video game that many fans have wanted for a long, long time. Alcat Games has released Warhammer 40K Rogue Trader, a new CRPG set within the world of Warhammer 40K. Alcat Games, of course, is best known as being the folks who made those two excellent Pathfinder games not too long ago. You know, Pathfinder Kingmaker literally led to a revitalization of that adventure path for 2nd edition and 5th edition. That's how popular it was. Now, reviews have noted that the combat can be a little bit tedious at times, but the game generally gives a spotlight to the rich world and lore of Warhammer 40K that we haven't seen in a while, and the story apparently is pretty awesome. Personally, I can't wait to play it. Unfortunately, PlayStation Network is down right now, so I can't download anything. Hopefully that gets resolved here soon.
But I want it now!
Anyways, that's all the news stories for us this week. Let us know what your favorite story was in the comment section below. And as always, don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons.